And welcome back to 1700 with Nick and Sarah. For Sin's show, Everything and Anything Australian Music, we're honoured to be with Biond in the studio today, and it is part one of our interview section. So Sarah's going to kick off the question with a fantastic question.
Yes, well, Biond, you just played your new single, Like He Never, which you performed early in the show, and it's going to be released on July 18th. Officially on all streaming platforms, which is exciting.
We got a sneak peek, which was awesome.
It was awesome, and it made us really want to get up there
and dance. Yeah, definitely.
Can you tell us a bit about this song and like what it means?
Yeah, so that was the world premiere.
Yeah,
so you guys got the scoop there.
We got it.
So it's called Like You Never, and that's because for me it was written at a time where I had just experienced that awful thing that a lot of people have in the dating world, where you kind of get fooled by somebody who kind of is just trying to pull you into bed, essentially. And you realize the next day or maybe a week later that that's happened to you. And it doesn't happen to you in that moment, but you like you realize that what you thought meant something might mean nothing at all. And so it was about that and feeling like I'd kind of lost that ownership of my body. And when you feel like that, and when you feel like you're in this environment where everybody can kind of fool you like that, you lose a lot of confidence to be in your body and move and dance. And so that's kind of where it came from. And that feeling of shame that you can sometimes feel from whether it's sleeping around or whatever it might be. And so this song is written for like when you need to pep yourself up and get back out there again and move and dance like none of it really got to you at all.
Yeah, awesome.
I really like that. Very powerful storytelling, especially through the components of dance and music. When you're writing these songs, do you have a particular area you start with? Do you start with the actual melody or the lyrics themselves, or is it always spontaneous?
That's a really, really good question. When I write, I try and make sure that there are kind of little riffs and ideas in the music. I think often we can start with that concept and get straight to the words and the lyrics and kind of skip over making it a memorable song just musically. So I think I probably would have started with that riff. And then I probably would have gone for lyrics. And then I try and write the melodies kind of like how they might be spoken so that it feels natural to me. Yeah, so I think that's the process of writing that kind of thing. I have a lot of references that I listen to as well. So I like to check back and forth. After I've written something, I go back and go, okay, how does this compare to what I had, what my dream was for the song?
Awesome. Did you, was that a similar way you wrote Immortalized, your debut single that you released last year?
So that one was really inspired by a song that I've listened to. I'm not going to tell you which one because I don't want to get sued. Just kidding. It's very, very different. But what I loved about that song in particular, it was a Tears for Fears song. And it just had this amazing construction where it started from like nothing, really simple, just piano and vocal. And it just took off from there and never turned back. And at the end of that song, there's this big refrain that after that refrain, you never hear back from the chorus again or any other part of the song. It just takes off and you just move from there. And I really wanted that kind of feeling so the construction came from that idea of starting really small and building and building and building and building. So that's why the kind of the beat doesn't hit until verse two. And then, it just takes off from there.
Really,
so that's
like
kind
that.
Of that process.
Very, keeping it very, you know, and in anticipation as well, you know, when's that beat going to drop, which is really cool. You have a really unique style for your video clips as well to accompany your music. Can you tell us a little bit more about them?
So, I mean, that style has come obviously from my imagination of what being Biond means and about that kind of nightlife and that neon and glitter and movement. But particularly for Immortalized, that kind of style and look came from working with Jesse Richards, who's a great friend of mine and a fantastic director. And the song is about being haunted by an old relationship that just feels like it's set in stone at this one moment in time. I don't know if you guys have ever had that one relationship that just feels like it's, you look back at it at its perfect moment when it was best. And so you always look back at that relationship and go and think about what could have been. So it's about that. So the music video kind of shows me being kind of haunted by these memories. But still within that kind of futuristic, neon, exciting world.
Really cool.
Awesome. How does it feel looking back at the video as well?
Mm-hmm. That's a really good question. I mean, I love it. It tells a really interesting story and it grips you until the last moment. So yeah, but it's also just so beautiful. And I was really lucky that I had an amazing team that day. So the lighting's out of control. And the, you know, the cinematography by Max Walter is stunning. So it was beautiful, yeah, there's a lot of light and a lot of movement and a lot of story. So yeah, I feel great looking back at it for sure.
Really awesome. There's been some fantastic questions and answers. We are in the studio with Biond today. Now, this has been our part one of the interview, but do not hesitate. We will be back with part two. So stay tuned. You're with Sin 1700 with Sarah and Nick.